In this video, we're going to talk about line integrals in the case that we're integrating not a multivariable function like we did yesterday, but in the case where we're trying to integrate a vector field. And just to make clear the distinction between these two, a multivariable function takes in a point, takes in an xy, and produces a single number, usually called z. So its input lives in two-dimensional space, and its output is a single real number living in one-dimensional space. But as we recall, a vector field was fundamentally different from that. A vector field took in a point and produced a two-dimensional vector, a list of two numbers. So its inputs are two-dimensional, a pair of two numbers, and its outputs are also two-dimensional. So there is a matching there. I mean to have different notation for the components. The traditional notation is to have a function p here of x and y, and a function q here of x and y. This is the traditional notation for the first and second functions forming the components of the vector field f. Now, you probably don't remember, but back when we studied the gradient vector in chapter 11, I issued a warning to say that the gradient vector was a vector, but it wasn't clearly denoted as such using boldface or using a vector arrow or using a vector bar. And in this chapter as well, we're generally expected to know and to remember and to be able to discern from context what is a vector and what is not, what is a scalar. So for example, we are expected to remember that outputs of vector fields are vectors. You're expected to know that, and not only will it clearly be represented by the notation. You will not always see that arrow, you will not always see that boldface or that overline. You are expected to know, generally, at this point in your mathematical careers, that the output of a vector field is a vector. And you're generally expected to know and remember at this point that the outputs of parameterizations are also vectors. So please do be careful, especially if this is your first class where vectors haven't been clearly indicated with that vector overline or vector arrow, to not take for granted that a quantity without an arrow is a scalar. You really have to stop and think, is this a scalar or is this a vector? You have to figure that out for yourself. So our goal for today is to calculate the line integral of a vector field as opposed to the multivariable functions that we did yesterday. And then we're going to do an application where we use line integrals to calculate work done moving an object along a curved path. And for our motivating example, let's go back to thinking about work done, and let's remember that if a constant force indicated by some vector quantity f acted on an object which was moving through a displacement vector represented by the letter d, the work done by that force on that object was given by the dot product f dot d force dot displacement. Now suppose you have a force field. For example, suppose you have an object which is emitting a gravitational force field. And that gravitational force field is acting on an object as that object moves through a smooth curve called C. Perhaps the object is in orbit around a planet. One could ask yourself, you know, how much work is being done by the planet's gravitational force field on the object as it moves in orbit around the planet? In answering that kind of question, requires us to calculate a line integral. We calculate f dot dr. This is the notation. Dot used for vector fields. When we want to calculate the line integral, we have the notation the integral over the curve C, the vector field F, the dot product symbol, and then the closing dr. This is the notation for line integral for vector fields. And it can be used, for example, to calculate total work done by a force field. Now, this is a situation where you're going to start to see lots of different notations and ways of depicting this particular quantity, because this quantity comes up a lot in physical applications, and because people are working with line integrals in physics and in math and in all kinds of different disciplines, everyone has sort of their own notation going. So you will see this notation for a line integral with f dot dr, but you will also see this notation sometimes used for a line integral, where here are the component functions of the vector field, and then here's the line integral over C, rho dx plus q dy, is an alternate notation for the line integral of the vector field f. Now, having established what the notation looks like, let's talk about how to actually calculate the line integral. Now, the first note is someone else has to give you an orientation of the curve C. The line integral's value changes depending on different orientations. If someone decides that you should traverse your curve C in the forward direction, and someone decides that they're going to traverse their line C in the backward direction, these will have opposite line integrals, C forward, C backward. These will have opposite vector line integrals. So when someone is telling you, please calculate this line integral, they need to have decided what orientation they are interested in for us to calculate the line integral. So you get that information from the person. You get the information about the orientation, the direction in which the curve should be traversed. Then, find a parameterization R of T for that curve, with that orientation. So as t increases, we should be traveling along the curve C in the direction that the person has specified. Now, once we have the parameterization for the curve C with the specified orientation, then we want to calculate the following. Calculate from the beginning of the parameterization to the end of the parameterization the following dot product. Not capital F of x, but capital F of the x of the parameterization. Capital F of the y of the parameterization. Now remember that the output of this function is a vector. And a vector can be dotted with another vector. So we are going to take the dot product of this force, of this vector output, with r prime of t, the derivative of our parameterization. And we're going to integrate that with respect to t. It's a single variable integral. So let's do a quick example to make this concrete. Find the work done by the force field f of xy equals in the first component x squared, in the second component negative xy. Find the work done by that force field acting on an object moving along the curve with parameterization r of t equals cosine t sine t for t running between negative pi over 2 and positive pi over 2. Well, this is just grand because someone else has not only decided how their curve should be oriented, but also they have decided on the parameterization that they want to use. Which means it just remains for us to fill in the blanks of this formula that we gave above, and then to calculate the value of this integral. So let's calculate the work done, which is the line integral over C of the vector field F. All right, so we have our force field, which is F of xy, which means that F of the x of the parameterization, F of the y of the parameterization, will not be x squared, but will be cosine squared t. Will not be negative xy, but will be negative cosine t sine t. Next, the next component in the integrand is the velocity vector for the parameterization. It's r prime, no magnitude, just r prime. So, taking the derivative component-wise of r of t, we have r prime cosine becomes negative sine, and sine becomes cosine. Now the next thing that we need to do is we need to take the dot product of the vector field and the velocity vector. So let's do that next. So let's do f of x of t, y of t, dot product with r prime of t. So we get cosine squared t times negative sine t. And we get negative cosine sine times cosine. And combining those, we get negative 2 cosine squared sine t. Finally, all that's left to do is for us to integrate from the bottom value of t for the parameterization to the top value of t for the parameterization. And we have the integral from negative pi over 2 to 2 of the result of the dot product, negative cosine squared t sine t. Now, thinking of this in terms of substitution, we could use, for example, the substitution u equals cosine t. We get an antiderivative of 2/3 cosine cubed t, evaluated as t goes from negative pi over 2 to t goes from pi over 2. Now cosine is equal to 0 at both of these inputs, which means that the total work done is 0. Now let's think about this for a minute. That doesn't mean that no work was ever done by this force field on this object. It just means that probably the work done by the force field on the object was positive at certain parts and was negative at certain other parts. Recall that work done by a force is positive if the force is in the same direction as the object's movement. But if the force is in an opposing direction to the object's movement, the work done is negative. So to get a total work done of 0, probably there was some positive work canceling out some negative work, giving you 0 work done overall. All right, now just as a friendly warning, the value of a line integral of a vector field, it doesn't depend on the starting point of the curve's parameterization, it doesn't depend on the parameterization speed, you can more or less choose any parameterization you want. But be careful and make sure that your parameterization for the curve that you were given respects the orientation of the curve that you're given. It has to traverse the path in the correct direction. So that will, you have to be careful about that. For example, if you decided to parameterize the circle in the previous example, this circular path here, if you decided to parameterize it with a different curve, a different parameterization, but which is still going counterclockwise, then you'll get the same outcome. But if it traverses it clockwise, this is opposite outcome. It will become negative of what it was before. Okay, so respect the orientation of the curve that's given to you. Make sure that your parameterization respects that orientation, or you're going to get the opposite of the correct answer.